God is good.
All the time.
All the time. It's good to be in the house of God.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Today we're going to start a new series. So today just going to be the introduction. It's going to be a long journey. But please give your undivided attention. And I believe that we all gonna be blessed. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Now, let's go into our Bible. And we're going to read, let's go in the book of Judges. Judges chapter 6. It's going to be a long reading. Judges chapter 6. If you are there, say amen. Starting from verse 1. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. And the Lord delivered them into the hand of Midian for how long? 7 years. And the hand of Midian prevailed against Israel. And because of the Midianites, the children of Israel made them the dens which are in the mountains and caves and strongholds. And so it was when Israel had sown that the Midianites came up, and the Amalekites and the children of the east, even they came up against them, and they came against them and destroyed the increase of the earth till that come unto Gaza and left no sustenance for Israel, neither sheep nor ox, nor hallelujah. Ready. For they came up with the cattle and the tent, and they came as what? Grasshoppers for multitude, for both they and the camels were with that number. And they enter into the land to do what? Destroy it. Hallelujah. So we see here, for 7 years, God allowed the Midianites to come and do what? Destroy them. After they sow, when it's time to harvest, the Midianites will come and they destroy it. We're going to read all the 18. And Israel was greatly impoverished because of the Midianites. And the children of Israel cried unto the Lord. And it came to pass, when the children of Israel cried unto the Lord because of the Midianites, and the Lord sent a prophet. The Lord sent a prophet. You know, they turned their back on God, and God allowed now the enemy to come and destroy them for 7 years. Now, they cry unto God. And look how this God is so good. Anytime you cry unto him, God does what? He answers. Hallelujah. Now, he said that the Lord sent a prophet unto the children of Israel, which said unto them, thus said the Lord God of Israel. Now, look at what now the prophet is telling them. He said what? I brought you up from Egypt. and that brought you forth out of the house of bondage, and that delivered you out of the hand of the Egyptian, and out of the hand of all that oppress you, and drove them out from before you, and gave you the land, and I say unto you, I am the Lord your God. Fear not the God of the Amorite, in whose land ye dwell, but ye have not obeyed my voice. Hallelujah. So children of God, it will let us know that every single thing that you are going through, every problem you are going through, there is a source. Hallelujah. Nothing will come to you without cause. And here, God now is speaking unto them. For 7 years, they harvest, they toil, they sweat, but they cannot eat the fruit of the labor. And when they cry unto God, God is coming and God is telling them exactly why they are going through what they are going right now. Hallelujah. Amen. I brought you to America. Hallelujah. I gave you that job. Hallelujah. I gave you 3 stimulus. Hallelujah. I can hear you. Hallelujah. Yes. But here you are on Wednesday. Some maybe since we started this year, they never connect even on Wednesday. Hallelujah. They think it's only on Sunday. Hallelujah. Children of God, God is speaking here. He said what? God is telling them here. He said, I deliver you out of the hands of the Egyptian, out of the hand of all that oppress you. I drove them from before you. I gave you the land, and I say unto you, I am your Lord. Fear that the God of the Amorite, in whose land ye dwell. No. You refuse to obey my voice. Hallelujah. And I say unto you, verse 11, and there came an angel. See how God works? Then came an angel of the Lord and sat under an oak which was in what? Ophrah. That pertained unto Joash the Abiezrite, and his son Gideon threshed wheat by the van press to hide it from the Midianite. Now here, the angel of the Lord, we know the angel of the Lord. Who is that angel? Jesus. Hallelujah. In the Old Testament, Jesus used to appear as the angel of the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, when he appeared here, he saw whom? Gideon threshing wheat by the van press and was hiding it from the Midianite. Why Gideon was hiding it? Because he knows that anytime it's harvest time, the Midianite will come and take our good. Hallelujah. If we sow so much, all the neighbor, they will come with the animals and they will come and they eat our good. So he was hiding. Now pick up on this. Verse 12. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and say unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. The Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. Underline, mighty man of valor. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. And Gideon said unto him, oh my Lord, if the Lord be with us, if the Lord be with us, why then is all that this befallen us? But God already answered. Hallelujah. You see, we heard the answer of the Lord God. God already answered. He said, because of what? Disobedience. But here, Gideon, he's asking again. He said, if indeed you are with us, Why is this thing coming upon us? And look now here. You know that God answered to all our questions?
No.
Why? Because He is God. Hallelujah. He owe you no answer. God, He owe you no answer. But we owe Him answer. Hallelujah. We answer Him to everything. Nobody will say, God, this one I will not answer you. Hallelujah. No, you answer to Him. Hallelujah. But God does not answer to us. He's God. Hallelujah. He can answer or not say anything. He's still God. Hallelujah. Many people are dying, but God is still. Like somebody, a priest died in my country. So when he died in my country, some people, they will say, oh, let his soul rest in peace. But a lot of people say, let him die in hell. Because of he was too evil. Hallelujah. And somebody was saying that, hey, he died too, but God is still there. Hallelujah. So with all the evil that we are doing, at the end of the day, we die. Hallelujah. Vanity upon vanity. Now look here. He said, and Gideon said, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befallen us? And where be all his miracle which our father told us of, saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hand of the Midianites. Now, look here. We're going to see if God answered. And the Lord did what? The Lord looked upon and said, okay, my son Gideon, this is this. No, hallelujah. God will answer. God already spoke. Hallelujah. Now, do we know why they are going in this situation? Do we know? Do you know why they are going in this situation? Yes, you know, you just read. Disobedience. Hallelujah. God said it. Now here, look how Jesus answered. And the Lord looked upon him and said, Go in this thy, hallelujah, and thou shalt save Israel from the end of the, hallelujah, ever not sent thee, underline, go in this thy might. Go in this thy might. Hallelujah. Go in this thy might. Now, God did not answer him. Hallelujah. He is God. Because God already said, the reason why you suffer is because of what? Disobedience. Now, God is telling him here, you underline two key words. Hallelujah. What is the first thing that you underline? Mighty man of. And number two, you underline what? Go. You see what? Go in this thy, and thou shalt save Israel. And thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianite. Ever not send thee? Now, we continue only to 18. And he said unto him, oh my Lord, wherewith shall I save Israel? Wherewith shall I save Israel? Now look here. The angel appeared to him. He was complaining, he was hiding. And God called him mighty man of valor. Hallelujah. And then he said, the Bible said, the Lord is with you. He said, if God is with me, why all these things? Which means that if God is with you, those things cannot befall you. Is it true? If God is with you, all those things cannot befall you.
Yes. But it just depends on us.
He said, the Bible, the Lord appeared to him and say, God is with you, mighty man of valor. And Gideon said, if God is with me, why all these things are coming upon me? Why they are coming upon us? So my question, if God is with you, so the evil cannot come upon you? If you allow it.
If you disobey.
I know the Bible says in Psalm 34, 19, what? Many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord God delivered him from them all. Hallelujah. But you need the presence of the Lord God for you to do what? To overcome. Hallelujah. Now, here, God said now, mighty man of valor, go in this thy might. What is the might that the Jesus is speaking about? His presence. What is that might? The power of God. What is that might? He said, go now in this might. Has the Holy Spirit. Remember, let me put together. Gideon, you are a mighty man of. Gideon, you are a mighty man of. Now go in this might and deliver my people, Israel. What is that might?
The mighty man of valor. The mighty man of valor. The title that God called him.
Children of God. Go in this revelation. You are a mighty man of valor. Hallelujah. Go in this revelation that you know now. I reveal unto you, you are a leader. Now walk in this revelation. Hallelujah. Children of God, this is what he's telling him. And the series that we are learning is what? Recover your stolen identity and reclaim your misplaced destiny. Hallelujah. Recover your stolen identity. He did not know his identity. God now is telling him, you are a mighty man of valor. Now that I told you who you are, you walk in that might now. Hallelujah. That's what the Bible says. The truth that you know, that the truth that will do what? Will set you free. Hallelujah. Now look here. You see two things here. Number one was what? Identity. Hallelujah. You are a mighty man of valor. Number two, it was a misplaced destiny. Now, here he's telling him, go now in this might and be the leader and save my people. Look at the answer of Gideon. After Jesus appeared to him, you see what he said here? Verse 15. And he said unto him, oh my Lord, wherewith shall I save Israel? Behold, with what I'm going to save Israel. God just called him mighty man of valor. Hallelujah. By him now, he opened his big mouth. Hallelujah. And he said this, behold, my family is. My family is. Did God ask him? Did God didn't know that his family was poor? Did God did not know that? He knew it. Hallelujah. And then he said here, my family is poor, so what? Who came here rich?
No.
Who came with Louboutin?
No.
Who, when they gave birth to him, he came with Louis Vuitton or Versace? Hallelujah. We all came naked. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, my family is how? Poor in Manasseh. And because Manasseh was a tribe, and it was the poorest tribe. Out of the 12, Manasseh was poor. So the tribe Manasseh was poor. Hallelujah. In that poor tribe, the family of Gideon, it was the poorest. Hallelujah. So poor call you even poor. So the tribe was poor. And the family, you know, the tribe might be poor. We know a poor country, hallelujah. But there are some rich in that poor country. But him, the tribe is poor. And his family is poor, hallelujah. You know, some of the people, you look at them, you say, this one, they are poor, hallelujah. Even poor is afraid of them. Now, children of God, he say here, and I am the least in my father's house. Hallelujah. Now only Manasseh is poor. My family is the poorest. And I am the least. Hallelujah. He didn't know how God worked. This is what qualifies you. God loves people like this. Hallelujah. When you are poor, when you are the lowest, when nobody can look at you, that's when God takes you. Hallelujah. He used the weakest thing to confound the wise, the strong. This is the doing of God. When you think that you are not qualified, God says, I qualify you. So that when God elevates you, you will know it's not because of your background, it's not because of your papa, it's not because of your mama, it's not because of the country, it's because of the King of Kings. That's why you are who you are.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of the parents, the only reason they are enjoying the blessings is not because of them, it's because sometimes the children of God, hallelujah, because there is one that God already chose in that family. And God provided unto the father and the mother so they can nourish that child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Children of God, every single thing is by the grace of God.
Amen.
Every single thing is by the grace of God. If you want to deny, God will teach you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's why you see some of the parents, they think that the children, they are what they are because they have money. No, God will prove you wrong. That's why you hear some women, they are crying. Look at my daughter. I buy you this. I send you to the best school. I send you to America. Look at you. God is teaching you. It's not your money. It's not your connection. But it's grace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Children of God, now look here. He said here, and the Lord said unto him, verse 16, and the Lord said unto him, surely I will be with and thou shalt smite the as one. And he said unto him, look at this guy. He's still not satisfied. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he said unto him, if now I have found grace. You already found grace, my brother. Hallelujah. For Jesus to appear unto you is grace already. He said, if I find grace in thy sight, then show me a sign that talk with me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, this is the type of the prayer people say, a prayer for sign. Hallelujah. And you know, when I was in Benin, I wasn't really praying. Hallelujah. So my sister Dora used to tell me, oh no, you know, when you pray, ask God for a son. I said, I don't believe in those things. So she was narrated to me the story about one of our cousins. So that cousin, she was, because we all grew up in Catholic church. So that when all the Pentecostal movements started, everybody started going over there, and they think they were holy, too holy for us that we're going to a Catholic church, so they thought that we are still little devil. Hallelujah. So now, she was praying. And my sister told me that she was praying because she was in love with someone. Then she want God to confirm to her if that monkey was her monkey. So my sister said that she prayed, she fasted. After 3 days, she didn't see the guy. So the guy always wear a hat. So she said, Father, if it's him, the day I'm gonna meet him again. Because they used to talk. He said, the day I'm gonna meet him after my prayer, he will have his blue hat on him, and he will hug me like never before. So I was just listening to my sister. Me not going to church, hallelujah, and fighting all those Pentecostal people because I'm still Catholic, hallelujah. So I thought the Catholic were angel and then they evil, hallelujah. Not knowing that I would be a pastor one day. So now, I said, so what happened? She said that after she finished praying, I guess the fourth of the fifth day, she saw the man. The man was wearing a blue hat. And the man came, he jumped on her. And then I said, so that was the sign. That was a magic. I said, that's a lie. Oh, you don't know because you don't pray. That why you don't need prayer. If you love each other and you don't see each other for 3 days, when you gonna meet, how you guys gonna meet? You gonna jump on him, you will kiss him, you don't need God for it. Hallelujah. She wastes a time of eating fufu and pepper soup. Hallelujah. Eat somewhere, eat wherever, hallelujah, and daring wait just to prove that this monkey belongs to me, hallelujah. With that prayer, after 3 days, it will jump on you. It will be all over you, hallelujah. Children of God, don't pray a prayer of sign, hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't have to pray a sign. Are you guys praying the prayer of sign? Do you guys ask the sign? No. And you know, sometimes, and the sign that you ask is always easy.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. It's always easy. I want you to ask a sign. Hallelujah. For those of you who ask a sign, I want you to ask a sign. Hallelujah. Say, Father God, if this one truly is my monkey, the day I will see him, let fire come down from heaven. Ask those type of sign. Hallelujah. Let fire come down from heaven on my left side and on my right side. If I see fire and fire here, I will believe it's him.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And now you say, and those are the type of signs you should ask God. Is there anything too hard for the Lord? No. Why are you gonna ask God that when the monkey see me, the monkey will jump, it will be over you. All of you will be on the floor. This is playing with God. Hallelujah. Now, look verse 18. Depart not hence, I pray thee, until I come unto thee, and bring forth my present, and see it before thee. And he said, I will tarry until thou come again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, children of God, the Bible says that you cannot see, you cannot see God. You cannot see God and remain alive. Hallelujah. But here, they were able to see Gideon saw Jesus. How come he didn't die? I don't know if where I'm glad this thing. How come Gideon saw the angel and he didn't die? Jesus ever appeared to you? Yeah, he appeared to you. But did you die?
No.
Why? So who is lying? You cannot see God and remain alive. In the Godhead, we have God the Father. Nobody ever see him. Hallelujah. Jesus said that nobody ever see my Father except the one who came from heaven, him himself. Hallelujah. But God the Son, we see him. Hallelujah. So God allow us to see him through God the Son, but we don't see God the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, so we're gonna dive now into our series that we started. So we were just reading. Hallelujah. For those of you who never read for a long chapter like this, it was an exercise. Now, so the title of the message is what? Recovering your stolen identity. Hallelujah. And reclaiming your misplaced destiny. Now, we're gonna talk about identity theft in the real world. Now, children of God, in this real world, so that we can understand, we have a better understanding of the series that we're gonna start. It's gonna be very good. Hallelujah. Some of you, you're gonna see yourself. Hallelujah. When you discover your new identity, you will be flying. Hallelujah. No, flying into your place of nourishment, not flying like witches. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, Number things that we need to know. First step of identity theft is what? Is acquisition of personal data. So when somebody steals your personal information through what? Hacking, phishing, scam. Hallelujah. So number one, they steal what? Your information, your personal information. Number two, after they steal your information, what they do with it? They use it. Hallelujah. If you have experienced this, I experienced one time, I filed for my tax return and I was hoping a big return. Hallelujah. So when I submit, they told me somebody already submitted it. And they called us before in our job place that they were a bridge. So they were a bridge. That was, I guess, 5 years ago. See, if there was a bridge, and you know sometimes it happened to also at a Target. They that used the car at Target, they were also bridge. So, and my job place, though, they proposed to us a service for free for 1 year to protect our social security. But somebody stole my social security. So what they do, they steal first your information. And number two, what they do, they use it. Hallelujah. That's the reason why they are stealing it. And then they do what? They use it. Now, I want you to understand this one, how we lose, how they steal identity in this real world. Now, how they use it, they can open a new account. They can take over your existing account and they can withdraw money. Hallelujah. Amen. One time I was going, it was the church account. Then I saw a cleaner in Russia. They withdraw money. I said, how come we are here and this one is the church account? How come is the cleaner in Russia? But they returned the money. So children of God, that's what they do. Now, and then the next step is what? You discover and you correct. But let me tell you, do you notice right away when they steal your identity? No. It takes sometimes years for you to know. The reason I knew is because I wanted to do my tax return. Hallelujah. I needed my money. Hallelujah. Then I found that. But some of the people, they don't know. Like this lady in my job place, her father is dead, but she's using her father's name and get credit cards and swapping. Hallelujah. So children of God, by the time you discover, it might be late. So I identify here 7 types of identity theft explained. Number one, we have what we call commercial identity theft. So this one, somebody is using your personal information, is using another person's business to obtain credit. Hallelujah. Yeah. He used another person's business name to obtain credit. So he used your name, the name of your business, because the name of your business has is honorable, so he can get what? Credit. We also talk about financial identity. This one, they are using another identity to obtain what? Goods and service. And this one, criminal identity theft. You are posing as somebody when they catch you. Hallelujah. So those are the type of scenario. We have another one, identity cloning. Now, identity cloning, in your daily activity, you try to look like somebody else. Hallelujah. So if you are in this country, you don't have paper. Hallelujah. I can hear you. Hallelujah. Because you are not in it, say amen. Hallelujah. I know you. Now, you want to use passagiste, paper for you to work. Hallelujah. So you have to look like passagiste. If on my ID they say I wear glasses, and I really wear glasses, medical glasses. And you don't wear glasses. Hallelujah. I used to work with one guy. He was all the time like this. I said, man, what happened? What happened to your eyes? He said, no, I'm not doing good. But go see the doctor. Go see the doctor. No, it's okay. And the man was wearing glasses too. Then later on, he quit. So they asked me why he quit. He said, no, he was using somebody else's paper. And the person wear glasses. So before they give him the job, they say, no, you need to wear glasses. And they gave him glasses, he's supposed to wear glasses. And that man was almost blind, hallelujah. So for him not to wear glasses, it was hard for him. But this is what? Identity cloning. So you try to be like a person, you try to look like a person. So your name is Shonkonono. That's your real name, hallelujah. But in the job place, your name is Gisle, hallelujah. So sometimes they call you Gisle, you forgot that is your name, hallelujah. I know a lot of people, one guy, I came, I used to call him by another name. Then he came to me, he said, hey, between you and me, my real name is Eric. I said, oh, okay. So children of God, this is what? Using another information to assume the individual identity in daily life. We have also medical identity. This one you use somebody else so you can get drugs. Hallelujah. Amen. And another one, social. Social is somebody is using your story to create his own page. Like here somebody had a foundation, Mandela Foundation. That person received a lot of money and they realized it wasn't Mandela. Hallelujah. It was just a white guy here in Illinois collecting money, but he used Mandela. Hallelujah. So it's like somebody using Pastor Jesus and start collecting money. Hallelujah. I will come after you. Don't make money with my name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, children of God, question: what is identity and what is destiny? What is the difference between identity and destiny? Before you know that your identity was stolen and your destiny was misplaced, how can you define identity? What is your identity? And what is your destiny? Let this side think about identity and this side think about destiny. Okay. Let this side think about identity and the other side about destiny.
No, we'll take destiny.
You take destiny. Identity. What is identity?
Personal information.
Anybody, what is identity?
Who you are.
So Mr. Window answer for you guys, who you are. But there is nothing over there, hallelujah. No error, hallelujah. Don't scratch. What is destiny?
The purpose of your life.
The purpose of your life. Do you have a destiny?
Yes.
So you're afraid to say, do you have a destiny?
Yes.
Yes. And what is that destiny?
Serve God.
To serve God. Do you have an identity?
Yes.
What is your identity?
Christian.
Always hear, so I'm the bomb. Now you are afraid to tell me that you are the bomb. Wow. Children of God, say with me. Identity, I cannot hear you.
Identity
is who a person is.
Is who a person is.
Hallelujah. Amen. Truman College, simple.
Oh, yeah.
All of y'all give you just F. Hallelujah.
No, Mr. Window, answer for them.
No, on this side, F. Hallelujah. Mr. Window, he just passed a test that he wasn't called to pass that test. So he received also an F. Hallelujah. Now, identity is who a person is. Hallelujah. It tells us on the surface who you are. Hallelujah. Now, I said this in spiritual terms. Identity answered the question, and this is the question identity answered. Who has God called you to be? Who has God called you to be? Who has God called you to be? That's your identity. Hallelujah. So, He has called you to be a pastor. Pastor is my identity. He has called you to be a musician. Musician is your identity. He has called you to be an engineer. Engineer is your identity. He has called you to be a giver. A giver is your identity. He has called you to be a mother. A mother is an identity. I can hear you.
Identity.
Hallelujah. He didn't call nobody a she, he. Hallelujah. He either called you he or he called you she. Hallelujah. If you are a she, he, or a he, she, you call yourself. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, this is your identity. Hallelujah. Now, we're going to continue. Thank you, Jesus. So, what is destiny? What is destiny? What is destiny? What is destiny? We say identity is
who you are.
And identity answer to which question? What God call you? What God call you? Hallelujah. Now, destiny is what you do now based on what God call you. Hallelujah. Now, I am called pastor. Now, what I'm doing is what is my destiny. Gideon was called what? A mighty man of a leader. Hallelujah. What is destiny? Leadership. Hallelujah. He has an identity, and the purpose is the action that reflects his identity. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, look here. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I'm gonna stay here. So you have the definition. Brother Eric gave you the definition.
Yes.
You're writing down?
Yes.
Now, look here with me. Really quick. Psalm 71, 70. Psalm 71, 70. So you understand. Psalm 71, 70. I want to clarify this because some of you think that your destiny, it has to do only with preaching the word of God. That's what you guys think. Hallelujah. Some of you think that only pastor knows his destiny, his purpose. No. Hallelujah. You all have an identity. Hallelujah. God called you. Now, your purpose is what are you doing with that identity? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Now, look here, Psalm 71, verse 10. Really quick. Psalm 71, verse 10. No, Psalm 71. Say verse 10. Psalm 71. Psalm 71. I have different scripture that I wrote here. Please, just go with me. Acts 13:36. Acts 13:36. But before we read that, Acts 13:36. Acts 13:36. Now, children of God, here, before we read that, God called David, hallelujah. When he called David, he sent prophet who? Samuel. I say Samuel. Don't say Samuel, that you're calling your husband. Samuel, hallelujah. He wasn't Sam. He was prophet Samuel, hallelujah. Not Sammy, Samuel. Now, God sent prophet Samuel to Jesse's house. Where were David at that time? In the bush, hallelujah. Doing what? Taking care of the sheep. Taking care of the sheep. Hallelujah. So God called him. And God gave him what? Identity. And what is that identity that God gave him?
Shepherd.
A shepherd. Hallelujah. Now, if he's a shepherd, what's gonna be his destiny? If I'm a teacher, my identity, I'm a teacher. What's gonna be my destiny? Teaching. Hallelujah. If you are a thief, what's gonna be your destiny? Stealing. Hallelujah. To wake you up. So, children of God, this is, he was a shepherd boy. Hallelujah. Smelling sheep. And God called him. Hallelujah. Now, look what the Bible says here. For David, after he had served his own generation, but the will of fell on sleep and was laid unto his and so, hallelujah. Now this David here, God gave him identity. He called him a shepherd, and David shepherd Israel, hallelujah. He shepherd, he fulfilled his destiny and did what? Die. Hallelujah. So, children of God, this is what we need to understand. Now we are going back in the case here of Gideon, and we see here in Judges chapter 6, Israel is living under the oppression from the enemy, the Midianites. Hallelujah. And Gideon here, he was hiding from the Midianites. Now look here, the God-given identity and the God-given destiny of Gideon that we just read in the book of Judges chapter 6, 12 to 14. Judges 6, 12 to 14. The Bible says what? And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. This is God-given identity. Hallelujah. God is not calling you by circumstances. God is not calling you by what you are going through. God is not calling you by your background. Hallelujah. God is calling you according to his divine agenda, according to his purpose, according to what you already declared. Hallelujah. Jeremiah, before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you and I set you apart as a prophet. Hallelujah. From his mother whom he was already a prophet. Whether the devil like it or not, he's a prophet. Even though he was born not in the hospital, he's still a prophet. Amen. Even if they did not organize baby shower for him, he's still a prophet. Hallelujah. Is to let us know that we worry too much about certain nonsense in the society. Hallelujah. We, when we see a baby that is born, she's cute, her jewelry is cute, hallelujah. God does not see that. God is seeing what? Another soldier, another great daughter, a physician, a woman to be, a lawyer, a doctor, a father, a president. This is what God is seeing, hallelujah. An evangelist, a prophet. This is what the Lord God is seeing. It doesn't matter whether your parents, they don't have money or they have. It doesn't matter whether they reject you or not. It doesn't matter. You are here on earth.
Amen. Amen.
This is the identity. But the devil is stealing your identity. Many of us, if you don't know your identity, your destiny shall be misplaced, because you will be doing what you are not called to do. Hallelujah. Amen. Mr. Window, he gave us a great answer, yes or no?
Yes.
But he was misplaced because it wasn't for him. Hallelujah. It was for this section. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, children of God, the Bible says what here? He said, and Gideon said unto him, oh my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befallen us? And where be all his miracle which our father told us, saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hand of the Midianites. And the Lord looked upon him as he's looking upon us today and said, go in this thy might, and that shall save Israel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Children of God, go in this thy might, and that shall save what? Israel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, children of God, just really quick, three things that we need to learn from Gideon's identity and destiny. Three things. Number one, say with me, God Himself, God Himself initiate your identity and your destiny. God Himself initiate your identity and your destiny. Hallelujah. It's God who created you. Hallelujah. When we create this one, we are the one who created. We say, you, we're gonna call you iPhone 20. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at me. It's 20. Hallelujah. They made just for Pastor Gisley. So we call it iPhone 20. Hallelujah. No, 21. I forgot. 21. Now, children of God. Children of God, this is how you call it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The same way Adam did. When the animals were coming, he said, you, the way I see you, snake. You, gorilla. You, hippopotamus. You, monkey. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the name remained up to date.
Amen.
Now, children of God, God is the one who initiates your identity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Jesus, when he walked the earth, he did not let people identify him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He did not let people call him. He introduced himself to the world. Don't let the world define you. Don't let the world call you. You have to let the world know who you are. Hallelujah. Don't let the world tell you who you are. You have to tell the world know who you are. Hallelujah. That's why you heard him say, I am the light, the way, and the truth, the bread of life. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending. He introduced himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You introduce yourself.
Amen.
You have to know your identity.
Oh, yes.
When the devil attacks you, he knows your identity.
Amen.
But what he does, he steals your identity. Once you don't know who you are, children of God, you will not fulfill your destiny. You will not. Gideon did not know. The only thing Gideon knew, I am from Manasseh, the poorest tribe, and the least in my family. I'm not qualified. That's the only thing that he knew. Until the day Jesus appeared to him and said, you are not what you think you are. You are a mighty man of valor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say with me, I am
a mighty
man. Woman. So you just follow everything. I didn't know that the she was he. Hallelujah. Okay, let's repeat. I am a mighty
man
of valor. Hallelujah. I hear Mr. Window too. No, I know you are speaking for Mama Linda. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, look what the Bible says here. Ephesians 2 verse 10. Hallelujah. So we say God Himself initiates your identity and your destiny. Hallelujah. Ephesians 10:2. Really quick. Children of God, this series will help you. Hallelujah. You know, some of us, we think that what people say, hallelujah, then you are the bomb, hallelujah. You are only the bomb at noon, hallelujah. At night, you will fade away, you will detonate. Look here, Ephesians. Especially on the wedding day, then you're going to be a really bomb, hallelujah. No, my wife was telling me one time, the service started. The monkey was already at church. And the pastor could not wait. He started the service. The woman showed up. How many minutes late? Like 20 minutes or 30 minutes late. She showed up. And the husband was just like this. You know the monkey now, he became a gorilla. So when the woman came, the man said, where have you been all this time? Makeup. You don't even look cute. She was so sad. When she heard that, you don't even look cute. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even the wedding I officiated over there, they told me, Pastor, 5 p.m. Oh, that time I drove like a crazy. We were there like 4:55. I was on time. We waited. When the groom came, when the lady showed up,
2 hours, 3 hours.
3 hours later. And look now, they invite, it was black folks and white people. Mm. When we get there, white people, they were there. Black people, no. We start coming late, hallelujah. All the whites, they were there. I'm the one who was the man, I was the one who was telling the husband, no, don't be upset, it's your day. But pastor, I said, no, don't be upset. I was supposed to be upset too. But I'm the one who was telling him, no, no, it's your day, don't be upset, it's your day. So the man was just, he wasn't himself. And here he was just, oh, she be in 5 minutes, she be in 10 minutes, she be in 20 minutes. 3 hours. When she came, I didn't even recognize her. She got volcanic makeup. She was the bomb. Yeah, I did not recognize her. She was really the bomb. Hallelujah. I said, why? Is he the same one? Yeah, she was the bomb. Hallelujah. Maybe when the husband saw the bomb detonate on him, the heart was moving so fast, he forgot about everything. Hallelujah. But please be on time. Hallelujah. Because the bar has a time, hallelujah. For those of you who love to drink, the bar has a time. At one time, they will close the bar, hallelujah. That the time you see, certain black folks, they will come, they start asking, even the wedded people, oh, do you have a couple changes so we can buy some Heineken outside? Because they already closed the bar. Be there on time, hallelujah. Now look here. Ephesians 2:10. Are you there? Look what the Bible says here. For we are his workmanship. We are his work. No, don't put we. Say I am.
I am.
His
workmanship.
Created in Christ.
Jesus.
I've been created in Christ.
Jesus.
Unto what?
Good
works. Unto what?
Good works.
Which God will?
Has.
Which God will?
Has.
Man say will. Which God will?
No.
Which God had? Had is which tense?
Has.
Past tense. Which God had before or then that I should walk in them? I have been created in Christ unto good work. The works that God ordained before that I should walk in them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So children of God, God initiates your identity. He said, if anyone is in Christ, is a new, that's your new identity. Hallelujah. So children of God, I want you to know this. Here, God stepped into Gideon's everyday life. And God announced unto Gideon, His purpose, God purpose, God idea. Children of God, God will never step into your plan. No, God will never step into your plan. God step in his own plan that he had for your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God took Gideon by surprise. God has something in store for Gideon. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now I say here, you should take time and pray and ask God question. What have you called me to do? Have you ever prayed that prayer? What have you called me to do? Who have you called and create me to be? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Who is your identity? What is your destiny? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Who did you create me to be? That's my identity. What do you call me to do? That's my destiny. Hallelujah. So children of God, God initiated himself what? Your identity and your
destiny.
Hallelujah. Now children of God, I want to understand here. We're going to go in some of the example also next time. But I want you to know this here. We're going to see another point. I want you to read with me. We're going to go first. We're going to see number two. I give you number 1 point. Now I'm going to give you number 2 point because I see three things. See, looking for my second things. Hallelujah. Now, here, second thing, say with me. God himself turned my weaknesses into his strength. Hallelujah. Now we're going to read. Go with me. 1 Corinthians chapter 1. And we're going to read verse 26, to use my best English, 26 to 27. 1 Corinthians 1, 26 to 27. Are you there? For ye see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the
flesh,
not many mighty, not many noble are called. Hallelujah. Now, he said here, I want you to see your calling, my brother. I want you to see, did God call the wise? No. Did God call the mighty? No. Did God call the noble? No. But God had chosen the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. And God had chosen the weak things of this world to confound the things which are mighty. Hallelujah. Children of God, God in himself initiate what? Your identity and your destiny. And we say number two what? What is number two? Hallelujah. So your weakness, that's what the Lord God is using. Hallelujah. Your shortcoming, that's what the Lord God is using. Hallelujah. Wherever the devil look at you and say, because of this you are not qualified, because of this you cannot make it, those are the things that God will use. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So children of God, this is what the Lord God used for Gideon. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Gideon was not strong. Gideon was a fearful man. He was afraid of the Midianite. And when Jesus appeared unto him, he was hiding. But Jesus called him, you mighty man of valor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say with me, I will see myself. Not the way people see me. Not the way they won't see me. But the way God see me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Children of God, and how God see you. Say with me, In God's eyes,
I am wonderfully
and fearfully
made.
Hallelujah. I can hear you. Say wonderfully
and fearfully.
Hallelujah. I know some of the people, they are wonderfully, some they are just fearfully. Hallelujah. Like my men. Children of God, we are wonderfully and fearfully made. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, look here. Number three. God himself desires intimate relationship with us so that we can fulfill our destiny. You cannot fulfill your destiny by yourself. Hallelujah. You need God, and that's why God told Gideon, I will be with you. I will be with you. Hallelujah. When he said, go now in this might, he again said unto him, I will be with you. Without the Lord God, there is nothing you can do. Hallelujah. God is what? God is the vine, and we are branches so that we can bear much fruit. You cannot bear fruit if you are not a branch that is attached to a vine. Without God, there is nothing you can do. Hallelujah. You need the presence of God. You need the power of God. You need the anointing of God. You need God in order for you to fulfill your destiny. By strength shall no man prevail. It's not by power. It's not by might. But by the spirit of the Lord God. Yes, it's good that the Lord God called you. Yes, it's good the Lord God called you a mother to be. Yes, it's good the Lord God called you a pastor to be. Yes, it's good the Lord God called you a lawyer. On your own, you cannot do it. Faithful is he who called you. He also will do it. Hallelujah. If the Lord God called you, he will do it. If the Lord God said, he will perform it. Hallelujah. Your destiny, it cannot be changed. And that's why he's telling you, the thought that I have told you, they are thought of God and best to give you an expected help. You just walk with this God. Walk with him. Hallelujah. Know who you are. Know who you are, children of God. Know who you are. Children of God, when it comes to your DNA, here we play with DNA, hallelujah. We want to go to Maury's show so you can hear. When it comes to this child, you are the father. You don't need to go over there. You know it's your child, hallelujah. You just pay child support. But you have to know, we have divine DNA. You have the DNA of your father. We have been made in his own image and likeness. Hallelujah. And now today we resemble Christ. You are in the image of the Son of God. Know this. Hallelujah. You are up here. You are up here. Your identity has to do with what? Also with your position. We are highly positioned, far above every principality, far above every dominion. Hallelujah. You are above an ability. Amen. Know your identity. Amen. What destroy identity and destiny in our life? What destroy identity and destiny in our life? Number one, lies. Hallelujah. Lies. You are not good enough. It will destroy your identity. You are not good enough. Hallelujah. And some of us is our parent. They are telling you are not good enough. People are telling you are not good enough. Hallelujah. Amen. Children of God, you are more than good. Hallelujah. Amen. You are more than good. If God brought you here on earth, it's for a purpose. Hallelujah. God did not bring you here on earth as an accident. God did not bring you here on earth as a mistake. He brought you here on earth as a solution. Hallelujah. You are a solution to a problem. You are a solution to a circumstances. And that's what the Bible says. For such a time as this, the Lord God called you. Hallelujah. The Lord God called you. Hallelujah. I can say she was created for me. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Yeah. It's not my fault if you did not find your mic yet. Hallelujah. But I will help you. Hallelujah. We will pray. You will see him. He will come. Hallelujah. I know in this ministry, we'll be celebrating wedding after wedding. Hallelujah. Graduation after graduation. Baby shower after baby shower. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Believe it. Amen. Children of God. Those are the bread of the children of God. We don't have to bargain with them. No, we don't have to bargain. When they say you are a child of the Most High God, when you look at yourself in the mirror, you can see God, not the angel. Not the angel. They were not created in the image of God, but you. Amen. In the image of God. That's why he said, who is man that you are mindful of? You gave him dominion over every single thing you created. And man is a little bit lower than the angel. He did not die for the angel. He died for you. Hallelujah. Amen. The angel that disobeyed, there is no redemption for them. They're going to be destroyed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But for us, we have what? Redemption. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Know who you are. The devil knows who you are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why the mighty are falling. Lies. And also, say number one, lies. Number two, through past, your past. Your past will destroy your identity. Your past will destroy your destiny. You know your disappointment, the statement that you made, you want a month to anything. Hallelujah. You start defining yourself based on your failure. You start defining yourself based on your disappointment. Hallelujah. I know some of the women, the first monkey come, he dumped you, he deceived you. And the second monkey come, he dumped you and deceived you. And you think that you are not the bomb, you steal the bomb. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If nobody call you the bomb, you look yourself in the mirror and know that your father is calling you the bomb. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's because you gave too much power on monkeys. Hallelujah. You want them to say, there you are good, there you are the bomb. Then no. You gave them too much power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Know who you are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know who I am. That's why I see how I walk. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Now, children of God, here, what destroys your destiny and your identity? Problems. The mountain that you see. Hallelujah. Look at the Bible. They say that when they saw the giant, he said, when we saw the giant, we were like grass. We were like grass. Hallelujah. I remember one professor here, an American, he went back home to teach. So he was at the university. At which age you have to be at university?
18.
Look at the people who used to fail in high school. They don't even know. Which age? 18 at least. Hallelujah. Now he went in at university in my country, and he present his children. This is my son, 13. The son was just happy, so big. Hallelujah. And now they start asking people age. They start bringing the age low. Hallelujah. I'm 15. I'm like, children of God, the mountain that you see, the mountain will not define you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say in this life, we have many types of mountain. Some of the mountain, you have to cast them away. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of the mountain, you leave them alone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mountain, you are here, I have no problem with you. You bypass, you turn around the mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of the mountain, you do what? You have to climb them. Hallelujah. Some of the mountain that they are on your way, God allowed them not for you to cast them in the river, but for you to climb them. When you climb them, you are on the top. Then you experience, you have the mountain top experience. Hallelujah. And you thank the Lord God. So children of God, multiple problems that we are facing. Now, your background also destroys your identity. Hallelujah. Look, Gideon here. I'm from Manasseh, the poorest one, the poorest family. Hallelujah. Did Obama came from a rich family? He came from a rich family, but he ended up in the world. In the world. Hallelujah. Many people today, they have money. They want to come to America. They don't get visa. Hallelujah. A lot. And some without any effort, hallelujah, they took them from home, airport, and here, they are here. You with your visa, with your long English, your Francais, your wherever, they deny you. Hallelujah. Anytime you go to the embassy, deny, deny, deny. Hallelujah. But some free. Hallelujah. So children of God, here, your background destroyed. Because of your background, hallelujah. Oh, this is not for us, we black people. Who told you so? Hallelujah. Oh, this is not for me. Your background destroys your destiny and what? Your identity. And through what? You underrating yourself. You think other people, they are better. Hallelujah. And this is our problem. We think that other people, they are better. Hallelujah. I cannot hear you. Hallelujah. We think other people, they are better. Hallelujah. I cannot hear you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Especially the one who have wigs. That one I don't hear. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even though what you're wearing is not your hair. Hallelujah. Say amen.
Amen.
Children of God, some of us underrating yourself. Because other people want to tell you that black is not good. Hallelujah. Children, this is gold though. This is gold. Hallelujah. This is gold. They want to let you know that this is not good. Hallelujah. Here you are, you start bleaching like Michael Jackson. You bleach and bleach until you have nothing to bleach. Meanwhile, some they go even here to the sun so they can look at least like us. But you are bleaching. Like one lady, she was in the hospital. Jesus appeared to her. He said, you are coming out of this hospital. I heal you. Before she left hospital, wigs big like this on upon her head. God. High heel. Yeah. And bleach. Huh. She hit the highway. A truck came and ran over her. Broom. And she died. When she died, she was in paradise. And Jesus was, she saw Jesus. And that she was just as if she wanna be Jesus. And she said, what happened, my daughter? You lied to me. You lied to me. You came in my room. You said that you healed me. I will come out the hospital. You, when? Yesterday, which hospital? She gave the name. This is you. Yes, it's me. While she was talking, the wigs just followed her. She said, oh, so that was you. The angel could not recognize you. That one, they could not protect you. They thought it was somebody else. Hallelujah. So children of God, you have to be you. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Be you. Hallelujah. You know, underwriting, they make you think that what you are is not good. Hallelujah. That's why you see them watching all those Brazilian, those African, the way they did, because they don't have it. Hallelujah. But you, when you look, you have it. Hallelujah. Full package. Now, children of God, through what? Fear. Because of fear, you are afraid of what is to come. That's how your destiny is destroyed and your identity is how? Destroyed. And because of that, the result is what? You become a pessimist. Hallelujah. You know, the people that lost their identity, they are pessimists. They are very pessimist. Hallelujah. So there's no optimism in them. Pessimist in everything. It's not going to work. This one is not going to work. It's not going to be like this. It's going to be like this. It's not, because they don't know who they are. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You are hiding from public view. Hiding from public view. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You are shy for people. For God's sake, we are the same. Hallelujah. We are not different. But some, you hide from people. Because of your identity, you hide from people. Children of God, forgetfulness of who God is and what He has done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
These are the results when you lose your identity and misplace your destiny. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Forgetfulness. Forgetfulness of who God is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And unmet goal and aspiration. You lose the will to dream again. You lose the will to dream again. Some, they don't dream again. Because they deceive you. Only one pastor, Gislain, deceive you. How many pastors, Gislain, they are here? 100, hallelujah. Because one deceives you. And you want to terminate your life. You want to kill yourself. Here you name, you label all the monkeys, they are the same. We are not the same. Children of God, just because of one deception, you don't dream anymore. That's the reason why you don't pray. That's the reason why I don't hear you pray. Why? Because here you lack faith. You are losing faith. Children of God, you are being suspicious of everyone. You are living a life of no faith. You are living in what? Jealousy, pity. You hold grudges, hatred, vengeance. Children of God. And finally, you speak rashly and make stupid vow to impress others. Hallelujah. Why? Because you lost your identity. You lost your destiny. Hallelujah. Children of God, don't ever put your life in the hand of somebody who's going to be deceived. The Bible says what? Curse is a man who put his trust in another man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The one that you think that these are the one. David said, even my parents forsake me, God is with me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Even they forsake, God is with me. Hallelujah. That's the only person that you need. God, hallelujah. It can open every door, hallelujah. It can close every door. It can elevate you. It can restore you. It can deliver you. It can heal you. It can promote you. It can favor you. It can do every single thing, hallelujah. God himself. Please rise on your feet. We're going to continue next time.
Amen.
God is good. All the time. Please, as you recover now your identity, because I'm helping you to recover your identity. Hallelujah. So please come next time in your natural and new identity. Hallelujah. No wings. Hallelujah. No, how you call this? Some they are even up here. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. We're gonna give.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we are grateful.